I'm Brian Ward Perkins.
Elaine Fox.
I'm Adrian Hill.
I'm Lucy Kluver.
Christoph Fraser.
Sally Shuttleworth.
Darek Wojcik.
I'm Maud.
Emily Taylor Brown.
Philip Steer.
Melinda Mills.
Anton Jerusalem.
Nicole Grobert.
Petros Ligoxigakis.
Christina Dundi.
Donald Tam.
Suda Bano.
Michael Dustin.
Aditi Lahiri.
Nicholas Proudfoot.
Francis Ashcroft.
Rose Rickaby.
Yadvinda Marley.
Melissa Dixon.
Gregor Larson.
Vili Lehronwerta. Otto
Cassi. Reza Corporal.
I'm Alex Wood. And
Happy birthday, ERC!
ERC have funded us to look at the genetic basis of differences in responses to vaccines.
We are trying to reduce child abuse and improve parenting for low and middle income countries.
The origin and early development of the cult of saints.
Cognitive biases.
Diseases of modern life.
Health in the 19th century.
How the body and mind responded to sound.
Cities in global financial networks.
The digital transformation of labour markets.
Bugs in the sea.
What causes diabetes?
The plurality within Islamic thought.
Genetic factors underpinning human reproduction.
Establishment of infection in the insect.
How words are represented, particularly phonologically.
What industrial relations will look like in the future.
The printing revolution.
The effect of aerosols, small particles in the air on clouds.
The function of individual tropical tree species.
Nanomaterials by design.
And I'm studying the origins of dogs, pigs and chickens.
ERC has a proven history of funding excellent fundamental and groundbreaking research.
It allows you to invest, to follow your curiosity to the utmost.
It allows me to realize my research dream.
Long-term projects focused on fundamental science.
But I think the biggest success of ERC grants are the training of the postdoctoral fellows.
As a young researcher, it gives you a lot of credibility.
It's enabled me to do the kind of interdisciplinary work that would be really difficult with it, without this kind of framework.
Having a job contract that's more than 9 months is a luxury in itself.
All they care about is scientific excellence.
So I think the ERC is really vital to maintain that slightly more high-risk type of research that could ultimately lead to quite big step change.
It's a huge opportunity to take some risks but get some enormous rewards and to really address big, big questions.
It allows you to do some fundamental research without restrictions of national priorities or other things. You can just choose a topic and investigate it in full detail.
We're able to start this research when the phenomenon was still on the horizon and it was not yet widely recognized. So that now that it is becoming important to policymakers, we're already researching it.
It is really important to translate our basic findings, but there's still many basic things to understand.
Without blue sky research, you wouldn't have any applied research, and that would be the end of it, really.
They've all come from basic research carried out by people who are simply doing experiments because they have an inquiring mind.
If you think that you know from the top down about where things are going, then you're a hell of a lot smarter than anybody's ever been.
It's been enormously beneficial, not only for my science, but for that of many, many other scientists.
So thank you.
Keep going and fund more and more great basic science.
I wish the ERC a very long life.
Thank you. A big thank you.
We'd like to congratulate the ERC on their achievements over the last decade and hope that there will be many more decades of funding.
Here's to the first 10 and here's to the next 90 at least.